is the host of the Zodiac for the Libertarian Party of Texas, and has been introduced our first award winner this evening. The Exemplary Coalition Partner Award.
Are you here? negotiate for. But that's not what I'm up here for. I guess I'm going to start by saying that in my time as operations director, I have had the absolute pleasure of getting to work very closely with all of our volunteers, our officers, SLED, our county leadership, and it's been fantastic. The award for indispensable service is an award given to a volunteer whose efforts have elevated the party as a whole and who represents us with grace and professionalism. Our winner's efforts at the state capitol during the legislative session and ongoing pursuance, of positive connections across the state have turned around what people think of when they think of libertarians. They think of people with a positive attitude. They think of people who are trying to help others. And that's really what we're about. Freedom is a way to help others. With that, I want to say a huge thanks and offer this award to Mark Miller.
Cassie, Villela, I've honored her earlier in one of my speeches, but I want to recognize her again. The coalition building effort that we did in this last 2-year term has been absolutely instrumental to our success and is absolutely going to be instrumental to our success. You heard Jeff Geist at lunch, you heard Jeffrey Tucker just now. And these two speeches, I couldn't have predicted how synergistic they were going to be in terms of the messaging that is just exactly what we need to hear right now as a party to drive us forward and tell us what we need to do. And it also validates what we have been doing, particularly the coalition building rally. Arthur Thomas, everybody already knows. I just say the word. I just say the name, Arthur Thomas. Everybody already knows. Arthur, you're an anchor, you're a Michigan, you're a great friend. Ben Farmer, Ben was there, Ben was my best friend. He was there when I was 15, and I was 15. And serious question. But tonight, I had to pick one person to honor with this Champion of Liberty Award. And the person I chose was the very first volunteer in our all-volunteer organization. He was my very first director, and he's the architect of this state convention, Liberty Now, Mr. Timothy Martinez.
Much better. So she extolled the virtues of Alan as a father, as a son, as I've studied as a businessman and as an activist. And she basically wanted to thank everybody here for letting Alan come out and play. Alan, she said this, and it's absolutely true, is that Alan loved these conventions. And frequently, whenever he came to the conventions, he just held the court. And everybody loved Alan, and he was quite a driving force. And truly, one of my best friends, and I will always miss him and frequently think of him. But it was a few years before Alan got his diagnosis of terminal brain cancer that he told me, he said, John, if I ever get a short clock, which is his words, if I ever get a short clock and I'm on the go, I want to have a party beforehand. So I, you know, screw the funeral. If somebody has something nice to say, I got to understand my face. So whenever we got the bad news, on strangely on April Fool's Day, first April Fool's joke ever, we decided shortly thereafter to go ahead and have kind of a good send-off party for a good friend Alan. So we rented the Stagecoach Ballroom in Fort Worth, and we had hundreds of people show up. A lot of people here made a long trip to make that a very special night. Shout out to them. Anyhow, we really worked hard to make it a great night for them. Alan was a frustrated songwriter. He wanted to write songs. So we put a band together, and we played some Alan Patterson original tunes. We had a lot of people that came out and talked about their experiences with Alan and how Alan had impacted their lives. And it was all very moving, but really the highlight of the evening was whenever Kurt and Ben come up all the way from Austin. And along with Brooke Bailey, our acting chair at the time, got on the stage and presented Alan with the first Alan Patterson Award for Excellence. So, and we told Alan at the time, this is going to be an award. It's going to be basically kind of the I'll just call it the Best Picture Oscar of our awards. It's going to be given to the person who embodies Alan's ideals and has worked the hardest and has exhibited the excellence that he frequently did to advance liberty throughout the state of Texas, specifically with the Libertarian Party of Texas. And so whenever I announce who this person is, I'm sure a lot of people will say, oh sure, Spivey, push this guy through. Because I'm an advocate for the person who won this award. But actually, I didn't have a vote on this. I made some suggestions, so. But I didn't get a vote on this. But the person that won that I'm about to announce here does embody the excellence of Alan Patterson and the pursuit of liberty throughout Texas. He's a gentleman who tirelessly puts himself out there, travels the state, gets in front of the media. He is advancing our message in a very eloquent and great way. And I will say this, he is one of the most qualified candidates for a position in Texas politics history. And that's from any party, it's not Libertarian. And that person who is going to, who is winning the 2016 Alan Patterson Award for Excellence Cause of Liberty is more important.
Right, because maybe your time. If so, I think Alan would agree, though, that excellence probably is not going to be enough. But we also need a lot of hard work. We're not going to get there without the hard work. And so, but we can do it. All of us together can roll up our sleeves. We can sweat a little. We can apply some elbow grease. And we can end two-party rule, which is the first thing we have to do to get liberty. We've got to get rid of two-party rule. We are the political arm of the liberty movement. To do that, we have got to do that. I'm ready. Hope you are too.